Imagine having AI at your fingertips. Basically AI in Raycast. Completely aware of your workflow, of your system. No logins, no captures. It's just there, ready to be used. Let me show you what I mean. So here I've got an article that I'm currently working on, and I'm going to use that as an example. I'm going to select this intro text here, which is quite poorly written. And I'm going to open up Raycast and type in improve writing. I'll press enter. And notice how we can see the Notion logo and there's some selected text, and we get a response with an improved version of our text, which I can then press Command K and paste that back into Notion. And next up, I can select the second paragraph, and I'd like to change the tone so it's a little bit more friendly. And here we have our rewritten text. And on a second thought, I think it's a little bit too friendly, so I'm going to press Command K and ask AI to change the tone to professional. And I think that's much better, so I'll press Command K again and paste that back into Notion. So far, we've been using some of the built-in AI commands, such as the improve text and change tone of voice. But we can create custom commands on the fly. To show you how that works, let's create a title for this article. And I want the title to be based off of the first paragraph, so I'm going to select that. And then I'm just going to ask AI to give me 5 title options based on this. And once we have our response, because this is in the context of a chat, we can actually continue the conversation if we need to provide more context. So for example, I really like option 2, but I'd like to leave out the extra details and just keep it simple. My Raycast work. That sounds great. I'm going to go with that. I'll press Command K and I'm going to copy the last response and paste it in the title. This is a great way to quickly ask AI for something on the fly. But if there is a command that you use frequently, we can create this command in a more granular way. Let me show you how. Let's search for the Create AI command. And in the title, I'm going to put in Summarize Article. In the instruction, I'm just going to say summarize this article as a list of key takeaways. We can choose an icon for it, which will show up in the root search. And we can choose a creativity. For this case, I'm just going to leave it as medium. And let's create that. Now over here, we have an article from The Verge. And I'm just going to select the content of this article, open Raycast, and search for summarize article. Press enter. And here's the quick summary of that article. And because this is something I use quite frequently, I'm going to go back to this command and assign a hotkey to it, which is going to be option A. So next time I'm on an article, I can just select the content, press option A, and quickly get a summary of its content. I also want to create an AI command that will convert my JavaScript functions to TypeScript. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll open up Raycast, create AI command, and we'll call this one convert to TypeScript. And in the instruction, we'll type in convert this JavaScript function to TypeScript. For the icon, we can choose the code icon, and creativity will set this one to low. So here's an extension that I'm currently working on, and you can see how this contact variable is typed to any. So let's select this whole function here, open up Raycast, and convert to TypeScript. And you can see we get back a code block, and that's converted our function into TypeScript. One thing to note is that the email is actually optional. So I'm just going to go ahead and tell the Raycast AI to make it optional. And you can see that it has now provided us with a new function where email is optional, and it's also conditionally rendering the copy to clipboard action based on whether there is an email or not. So this looks good to me. I'm going to press Command K and paste that into VS Code. Up until now, we've been looking at how we can use these predefined commands to initiate the chat using the text selection as the context. But we can also open up a blank chat window by using the Ask AI command. And then from here, you can start asking whatever you want. You can still access your predefined AI commands from here. And like other AI chats, this is contextual, so you can keep the conversation going. And two last things from me. The first one is that we're going to be exposing a lot of these features through a first-class API so developers can build even better Raycast extensions. And two, if you're interested in anything you've seen here today, make sure to sign up to the waiting list on raycast.com/AI, and we're going to be rolling out the invites over the next few weeks. That's all from me. Thank you.